Hi, I'm Doug Christie, and although I think a lot of people may have already seen some of the things I have to say, I thought it'd be wise to give you a little background on who I am, where I come from, what I've done. I'm going to do it really quick. 5 minutes, I should be able to tell you everything that I can. There's a lot more detail, obviously. I was born in Winnipeg in 1946. I went to United College, where I got a Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy, Political Science, double major. Then I went to UBC from 1967 to 1970, graduated with a Bachelor of Laws degree. I articled in Victoria till September 15, 1971. I practiced law in Victoria from 1971 to 1984, representing everybody that I was asked to represent on a wide variety of things, mostly criminal defense, legal aid mostly, and the general run-of-the-mill type of charges, from murder or manslaughter all the way down to theft under $50. So I covered the gamut of criminal defense. And then in 1984 I was asked to represent and defend James Keekstra. That went to the Supreme Court of Canada twice, and I lost by 4-3 in the Keekstra case. Then Ernst Zundel asked me to represent him. I then represented him through two trials to the Supreme Court of Canada, where we won. I was asked to represent Malcolm Ross, Imre Finta in a 9-month war crimes trial, and that he was acquitted by the jury in about 2 hours. I was on the BBC explaining the dangers and difficulties of war crimes prosecutions. No one after Imre Finta was ever convicted or even charged with war crimes under the criminal code, although the law is there. It's never used again. Now they go under citizenship, where it's easy to prosecute the case because it's only on the balance of probabilities. The accused has no right to remain silent, and there is no jury. You know, those things that that caused the prosecution so much trouble in the Finta case, because of course after about $5 million in costs, he was acquitted, and the acquittal was upheld in the Court of Appeal and upheld in the Supreme Court of Canada, where a new law was made that obedience to superior orders that are not manifestly unlawful is a defense, unlike the Nuremberg trials. So, phone's there, but we'll carry on. Now, I just want to say that I've represented probably 8,000 cases in 37 years. I've always been a defense lawyer, and I enjoyed defending the rights of the individual against the state. I'm opposed to human rights legislation, which controls speech on the internet and on the telephone. That's Section 13.1. I opposed the hate law, which was used against James Keekstra, Malcolm Ross, Doug Collins, a wide variety of other people. I defended successfully Glenn Barr in Edmonton and Harkus and Scriba in Winnipeg. I've had many cases involving speech, particularly and defamation cases as well. I've been plaintiff's counsel in Pressler versus Lethbridge. I've been a plaintiff myself in the Bannerman case, which I lost, where I was called a perverted monster, and I lost that lawsuit, and that was a bit painful. But let me tell you that I've learned that you can't always rely on what the world says about you. You have to do what you believe is right. I've done it in as much as I could, to the best of my ability, for many years. I hope for a few more. And I want to thank all those wonderful people who helped me throughout my career. Arthur Bernard Russ, Davy Fulton, Charlotte Whitten, John Diefenbaker, all people I not only admired, but many of them helped me. I just feel that I have a great deal to be grateful for, and I've had a lot of blessings in life. If ever I can help someone else in difficulties, I think it's my way of doing what Barney Russ once told me to do, and that is pass it on. Pass on the blessings, and don't carry on with whatever hate you received. Usually that rebounds on the person who hates, and I don't. So I hope you understand a little bit more about Doug Christie, and there's a lot of bad things said, but I could deal with each of them, but it'd take a long time. So anyway, I thought I'd give you a little bit of a picture of who I am, what I am. I'm a defense lawyer. I founded the Western Canada concept in 1980 in the Western Bloc in 2005, and I've worked for the independence of Western Canada since actually 1974. That's a long time ago. But I still believe in it, and I believe that for freedom, we must have a new nation, because unfortunately the nation of Canada, as I see it, has become corrupt. Its laws have become oppressive and convoluted and diabolically twisted, and I'm not particularly impressed with the way they have been interpreted. Freedom is being eroded. Human rights tribunals can silence a person without the right of truth being a defense. I think it's ridiculous. I'm the only person who was ever banned from the precincts of Parliament, and the one thing I wanted to do was to speak in the parliamentary press gallery, which I had rented, which was rented to me, so that I could say that truth ought to be a defense. All three parties agreed, and the Speaker imposed the rule that I could not enter the precincts of Parliament to actually make that point. That told me all I needed to know about Canada, told me all I needed to know about the legal system, and I hope it gives you a little insight into who I am, and what I stand for, and what Canada is all about as well. Thanks very much.